Hello, Storic Tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play Shining Force 3 with me, Blue Ankylo. So last episode, we left Aspia and started journeying to Storic to stop the Barisol army from raiding it and thereby losing our food stores and all that. We made it about halfway, and then a bunch of extra units showed up, and we're gonna have to fight them off. So, I've got currently Symbios back here fighting off against one last little hellhound, but I think the bulk of the force will stay forward and deal with, you know, whatever comes up front. I'm gonna do the old Obrite defense boosting strat. Grace is gonna move up forward. Justin will, but I need to keep him sort of in the back because he's got pretty weak stats. We're not gonna move forward yet. Oh, they're heading towards Symbios, actually. That's interesting. But I didn't want to fight them with all that with Symbios. We're still training up some of our secondary weapons. You know, once Symbios gets his knife to level 2, I'll switch back to his main sword most of the time. It just takes a while to get there. Now, Horse, he's got kind of insane physical defense, so I like keeping him around. I've also boosted Noon, so he's got good defense at the moment. Plus, I betcha Hellhounds are weak to ice. So Free should do pretty good damage here. That seems pretty good. I don't know if he took any extra damage from elemental weaknesses, but... Hey, the spark spell! And see, when you're promoted, you do get a lot more stats every level up, so... The longer we stay unpromoted, the weaker we're going to be compared to the enemies. Like, it won't take long to fall behind a fair bit. But at some point, I'll promote everyone up and we'll catch up in levels just fine. So Spark, right. It's pretty expensive. It has the same range and effect as Freeze level 2. For one more MP and less power. So, it's not going to be terribly often that Spark 1 is better than Freeze 2. Unless an enemy is strong to ice, but weak to lightning or something like that. Which is hard to tell ahead of time, so... You know, I don't know if that's going to happen very often. I think once I move Symbios over towards the main force, these enemies will just sort of change their direction. Alright, coming at Sybil, eh? So I haven't seen any special attacks from the Hellhounds yet. I sort of assume they have something, but, you know, I don't know yet. Eldar is possibly my least leveled up normal use unit. And I blame her for not getting kills, so she's not getting as much XP as the rest of the team. We're gonna move Dantarez over here. The Hydra is a little intimidating, to be fair. Actually, I haven't even really looked at the Hydra's stats. How tough is a Hydra? It's not that bad. Unless it's got some kind of crazy, extra, like, super attack. So, Obrite did just get his level 2 in normal axes at long last. He still needs to level up his, tomahawks, but I think we'll get there. Also, more trusted friends. Really nice to see that after Obrite died earlier and I sort of lost all that progress. That was a little disappointing. So Sybil took a hit, right? Sort of. I could just go for more boosting. I'm gonna call it boost because that's what it was, that's what they called it in Shining Force 2, but it's support in this game. I could have healed her, but I think that just having some extra defense is probably a little bit better. And I think Grace will have enough MP, so nothing to worry about. Looks like you don't get a whole lot of XP from boosting in this game. They may have nerfed a little bit. Let me keep Justin back for now. Alright, so Sybil should be quite defensive right now, so I'm going to move her... just to make sure that if I kill this guy, the Hydra can't hit Eldar, but could maybe hit Sybil, and, you know, she'll be fine. I should really leave an enemy unit with low HP so that Eldar can get a kill. She'll probably get like 49 XP if she can kill anything here. So I want to lure the enemies back over, obviously. Now that Hayward has a Haywire range, it's much easier to get him in position safely, which is... definitely, this is the point where archers start looking a little bit stronger. A little bit more useful. Horse looks pretty strong. I like it. I did open up an attack on... oh, it gets a lot of attacks. That's kind of neat. I did open up an attack on Grace, but the enemy's not that smart. I think Irene's boost will wear off, but I don't think there's anything that can do much damage to her, seeing as the Hydra's about to die. She also has that Gale Ring, which gives her pretty good defense anyway. Oh, cool, she got her Tornado Spell leveled up. A little bit of MP, a little bit of defense. That's all you really need on your mages and your healers. So I don't know if Hydras are going to be weak to fire or anything, but let's see.
Here I come.
Normally I would think the Hellhounds and the Hydras might be slightly fire elemental, and that was definitely less damage than we usually see. I gotta remember they've got a big mage there. I don't want to be grouped up somewhere where this guy can hit me with his high level spell. Hey, Don Therese. You don't even need the kill, buddy. Alright, I'm not going to let Don Therese get the kill. I'm going to try to let Eldar get it. Yeah. So, Eldar, don't fail me. You gotta do 8 damage. This is your chance. So, I bet you if she hadn't got cross slash, she would have done like 7. Alright, there we go. Give me some stats. HP, attack, agility. Well, it's what you expect out of a bird, I guess. Now, I think moving that far forward would be a little bit foolish. It's a High Priest. Tornado 3 wouldn't be that powerful, but I don't want to get hit by it and everything else. I would like to lure just one of these guys. So, if I stand over here, maybe the mage will come at me. Sybil's not the best one for luring mages, but she'll be okay. I actually don't even care if Grace gets hit by the magic. I'd rather have Sybil at full health and let Grace take a bit of magic damage. She's got really good resistances, so it'll be reduced for her at least if she gets hit by the freeze spell. What kind of... I forget immediately. Oh, it's Blaze level 3. It's pretty powerful. We don't even have that yet. Are they going to just keep running all the way around that mountain? Surely they'll turn around. Alright. I do kind of want to lure that bird over as well. I'm going to put Horst right there on that good defense tile. Well, they've committed. They're just going to go that way. Alright. So I'm just going to sort of go with my my usual pattern so we don't get hit by AoE magic. Should not be a big threat. As one would expect. What do I think? Is this a good idea or a bad idea? The archer just went. Wish I had a level 3, a range 3 magic from here. I don't think that's very smart. Let's not do that. It's probably equally dumb for Eldar to do it. In fact, I need to remember to keep Eldar away from that sniper. So I'm going to move Eldar sort of over here to deal with the mage, wherever the mage goes. Put Obright here. Use Sybil to block the middle there. Yeah, we'll just go with this pattern. I do need to remember these Bear Soul soldiers are... They'll eventually catch up. Okay, the High Priest didn't attack anyway. So, from here... We just switch over to the Tomahawk. And start returning fire. Pretty good damage. Good job, Horst. Not gonna run forward with Irene either. Still, they don't turn around. Thing is, Dontrez doesn't have amazing defense. If I put him there, I bet you we'll get hit by Tornado. Thing is, Tornado might do 15 damage, or even more, possibly. And then it wouldn't take too much for him to die. And he doesn't get a defense boost from Horst. And I kind of want them to come at me, rather than me having me rush them. Horst can tank, though. He's fine. Alright, I'm gonna use Obright here. I kind of feel like him and, him and Horst should be friends anyway. Give each other defense buffs, that'd be super tough. Super strong tank line if I put them together. Well, we could attack. She's got that boost buff for a little bit longer. I don't know, this might be a terrible idea. I should have saved it. I'm getting awfully close to that boss now. Also, as long as I do so- Oh good, and then support wears off immediately. You know, as long as there's an enemy that's damaged, the priest will probably focus on healing rather than going offensively with magic. And we're not rushing forward with Justin, that's for sure. Yeah, so he's gonna kind of waste his aura here. That's actually really good. Aura's pretty expensive on MP. And, I mean, it's an AoE heal. Area of effect healing is pretty awesome, but, do I do it? I send Symbios in. Let's do it. I'll put Obright beside him. And the enemy will focus on him like usual. And we'll be fine. Get some help from Hayward here. Not a ton of XP. Actually, having Horst up here is not a bad idea. Having him friends with Symbios would be really nice as well. Let's try to focus on the flail first. They just don't want to turn around. Alright, now that's not going to do much. We've already learned that Yeah, the Wing Knights can't hurt the Horst. Probably get more damage standing beside Sidbyas, honestly.
Prepare to die.
Especially with that energy fall. Yeah, you know. Dantres doesn't need friends. There's not too much more to worry about over here. Well, how tough is the boss? 36 attack is pretty high. And he will do a little bit extra damage to the knights. But if I can get some damage on the High Priest will probably just heal himself. Okay, here goes. I'm glad I put Obright beside Dantres. Ooh, we got the skill! Oh man. Please don't use Tornado right now. Okay, we're gonna go and throw in a heal level 2 right now. I know we're all grouped up, it'd be a really nasty AoE spell, but. That was a little bit too much damage. A little bit too much. Alright, well, I don't think Justin's gonna do a whole lot here, but take a couple pot shots. I actually don't even really want to kill the Force Commander until I've killed all the other units, because, you know, maximum XP. Looks like we got maybe two more turns before those guys start becoming a problem. You went for Sinbios, eh? Yeah, with that extra weapon advantage, that's enough to hurt. Alright, he did go for the AoE. Well, it's because he could hit Sinbios with it, I bet. Let's see how much Tornado can do. Tornado 3. Oh, 8 damage to Grace? That's nothing. A little bit more to Irene. I don't think that's enough damage to be a big problem yet, really. Okay, I'm gonna put Sinbios over here beside Grace. I think I could kill the High Priest with a knife. Just knife him. That might do it. Ah. I don't think that really does anything, honestly. Alright, well, Hayward! I'd actually rather you focus on the this guy a little bit.
Bullseye.
That should put him to sleep if it doesn't kill him. Nice, that does do something for sure. Alright, Horst. You finish off this guy. That's your mace special. A big high, yeah. Irene, so what do we want to focus on? I rush to heal Dantres, he's fine. Grace will be able to heal over there. I think. Agility 10. Well, if we kill. If we kill the High Priest, which is the plan, then the boss could attack Sinbios. That would be deadly. So let's not mess this up. No one shall die! Gotta use those heals. Alright, Masquerade, or Noon, whatever your name is. Well, that will more than kill the High Priest, and it'll do some damage to the boss.
I'll bear my Arctic Blast.
Could have just used Freeze level 1, but, you know. You know how it is. It's 22 damage. That's pretty good. Alright, so let's see. I feel like putting Eldar by the boss. Even... Well... How much defense does she have? 16 plus, how many points with Obrite? That puts her at 23 defense. Boss could do 13 damage to her if he hits normally. If he gets a skill, I don't know how much damage that'll do. But there's no way he'll attack her, right? He'll almost certainly go for Symbios. Yeah, so let's not do that anyway. So, I forgot Obrite was going to... Well, I wasn't expecting Obrite to go before... I kind of did this wrong. Like, I wanted to have Obrite standing beside Symbios. 21 defense versus 36. He can still take some damage. Well, I'll leave Obrite here just in case he attacks Dantrez again. Which is going to be trouble. Well, no. We already learned that his skill can't one-shot him, so... I guess there's not a whole lot to worry about. We go for Dantrez again, okay. Two skills in a row. It's probably because he has weapon advantage. I bet you weapon advantage gives you skill activations as well as crits and all that. Alright, you guys are running in, so we'll start killing them. And I will put Symbios right beside him in the mountain. I don't even really want to kill him right now, but... Hey, he'll level up! Why not? A bit of defense, doesn't hurt. Ah, Symbios has lots of HP. Alright, let's start going to work on these guys. Seeing as Hayward has long range, we'll put him a little bit out to the side. Not, like, super amazing damage, but it's not the worst. Thinking of trying to block him in with, like, Horst and other defensive units so he can't get away. Make sure Dantrez is safe. Make sure Grace is safe. I know this means Irene is not safe. Who makes sure she's safe? Good, they're friends now. Alright, so this is kind of what I was hoping to set up. This should do lots of damage. This might even kill him immediately because of the boost for Masquerade, to be honest. Good. Almost, but not quite. It's good, because I kind of want Masquerade to kill that guy. How far can this... Oh, the mage is falling way behind. Alright. No, Eldar is at weapon disadvantage. I think that would be silly. I should give this kill to Eldar. She's generally having a hard time leveling up compared to the other ones. She doesn't do as much damage, she's kind of weak. Although it stole it out of Masquerade, but... I think Masquerade will be fine over here. Dantrez, you're gonna pull out of there as well. I'm gonna gonna put you over here just to save a spot, just in case someone can walk up to this guy to finish him off. Try to make it a little bit easier for them. Alright, now, I don't know what the boss will do, but I think with no other options, he'll go for... With no other really good options, he'll probably go for the person beside him. Yeah, they generally don't move if they've got a good target beside them, even if technically he could have moved and killed someone. If he has a target without moving, he'll do that. Yeah, we can do one more attack here. Shouldn't kill it. Shouldn't kill it. Oh good, that actually should make him a little bit more likely to miss on the next turn anyway. Actually should have left the space. I should have known she wouldn't kill it, so. I think Mascarina can take one hit. Aver, do you want the kill? Yeah, you almost got a level up.
Bullseye.
Awesome. No attack, but at least he got a little bit of other stats. First, just gonna sit here and wait. Don't want to kill the boss yet. So we need to heal up Mascarina. I think I'll leave Grace by Symbios. Oh, I could have healed Irene. That would have been smart as well. Let's keep her a little bit further back. She's only got one more real spell anyway. Just in case the enemy mage could hit her or something. Now, I did give her those healing herbs so she can keep healing anyway. The mage is not going to get that close anyway. Alright, next turn, we kill the mage. We'll start with Eldar. Once the mage is dead, we'll kill the boss, and we'll call that a battle. There you go, Eldar. You're tough enough to beat up on a mage with no defense. Now, because that mage uses fire, he might have stronger fire resistance than lightning resistances. So let's try out Spark level 1. I think I was correct, actually. That was pretty good damage. That was more than usual, I would say. Alright, well, I think that's it. So who wants to get the kill over here? I guess if Obreyte gets it, he'll probably get a level up. Protect Bracer. Well, I've got lots of those. It's not that important. HP, attack, defense. Perfect level for him. Alright, and that's a wrap.
These may be Republican forces, but if they defy the Senate, we must stop them. To do such a thing while the country is in turmoil, that's the worst part of all of this.
What? Look, Lord Symbios. Well, we're not going back to Aspia. The West Gate has been closed. We can't get back into Aspia.
Not only that, now we can't return to Flaggard either.
It must be. I wonder if they are trying to stop us from going to Flaggard. But why?
If that is their plan, Flaggard must be in danger. We must return there no matter the cost. But first, we'll have to explore this town. But that will have to wait till the next episode. Aw, we hurried, but the town's already been turned upside down. We're gonna cut the episode here, because there's probably lots of town exploring to do, and we'll save that for another episode. Thanks for watching, folks. Hope you guys have enjoyed. And I'll see you next time for more Shining Force 3.